Alright, now that it's the day after our sudden apocalyptic storm and snow and cold snap, whatnot, I'm gonna get back on the project. Didn't really expect for this to take 4 days, but it's hard to run the chainsaw when it's thunder and lightning, wind, snow. The chainsaw here is getting pretty wore out. As you can see here, there's no paint left on or anything. It's kind of starting to make it hard to cut things. So I'm going to put a new bar on here and see if that helps. I suppose it's so muddy down there, I think that's about as good as that's going to be getting for now. But we got to take out one more tree here, well, two more trees, three more trees, a lot of more trees, and do some more small stuff by hand. Nora's driving. Only 30 minutes for dinner. Pretty good. I'd say it's about time to take a break. All right, so I'm gonna take these chains off. We've got them kind of bungeed here. After that, head on over and move some logs, cut some trees, grind some stumps. Thanks to Niagara Garlic Farms for suggesting that we use the three-point hitch on this thing to try to pull the fence post out. Unfortunately, this one has been buried in the sand over the years because it's all washed off that hill up there. Washed in the years of the pasture and got stuck on the fence line. As you can see, this post isn't all that tall. It usually stands, well, if you can see that one up there, about 5 feet tall. I'd say there's 2.5, 3 feet of this post showing. So it's probably a 7 foot post, which tells us that it's buried pretty far down in there. So we might have to go get the big 656 and try the 3-point on that, see if we'll rip this out. Look at how deep this hole is. See if we can fit Andrew down it.
I can do 1 foot. I'm not at the bottom. I can't make it. That's a little deep.
It's a big post.
It's the whole of China.